Hello, good morning dear students. Welcome back to your English class. Students, in this class we are going to continue with the future tense. We have done with simple future and future continuous tense. In this class we are going to learn future perfect tense and future perfect continuous tense. These tenses are not used widely, but still we will learn these tenses. In some of the foreign countries these tenses are skipped, but let's learn future perfect tense. So future perfect tense, what is future perfect tense? So students, we use future perfect tense for all the actions which will be completed in the future time before any point of time. Okay, so this is the future perfect tense. Let's learn the structure. Subject plus will plus have plus verb's third form plus object. So this is the structure. Now let's take the example and understand it. Ram will have learned tenses. If you want to frame the question, will Ram have learned tenses? And now if you want to change it into negative sentence, then what you have to do, you will write Ram will not have learned tenses. So this is how you all can form the negative sentence. Now if you want to change it into interrogative negative, then you need will Ram not have learned tenses, and WH word, who will have learned tenses. So this is how you can frame different sentences, and if it is interrogative sentence, you need to insert the question mark at last. Clear? And if you want to frame it into negative, if you want to frame the WH word negative sentence, then what you will do, who will not have learned tenses. Okay, so who will not have learned tenses, and the question mark. So this is future perfect tense. I hope it is clear. Now let's move forward and understand future perfect continuous tense. That is future perfect continuous tense. So students, what is future perfect continuous tense? Student, we use future perfect continuous tense for all the actions which will be continuing in the future till the till some point. Okay, so we use future perfect continuous tense for all the actions which will be starting in the future and also will be continuing. Okay, so let's start this. First of all, the structure is subject, then will, then have, then been, verb's first form plus ing because it is now continuous tense, and then object. Remember, the object is optional. There is no need of writing the object always. It is optional. If there is an object in the sentence, then you can mention. If there is no object, then there is no need of mentioning the object, and then you will mention the time expression. okay? So this is how you can form various sentences, and you can also write since, for, and then the time, okay? Or you can also directly write the time expression. Now what is time expression? Like the whole day, whole morning, whole evening, all morning. So these are the time expressions. So after object you can directly write the time expression. Let me tell you the example. Ram will have been shopping the whole day. Ram will have been shopping the whole day. So this is in the future tense, that Ram will be shopping in the future time. Okay, so now the next is how to change this sentence into interrogative. To change it into interrogative, you need will Ram have been shopping the whole day. And then you will change it into negative, and to change it into negative you just need to add not after the helping verb. Ram will not have been shopping the whole day. Right? Now you will change it into interrogative negative. So to change it into interrogative negative, will Ram not have been shopping whole day? ? And now you will change it into finally WH word sentence. So what will Ram have been shopping? What will Ram have been shopping the whole day? You can mention whole day also, or it is not necessary. Now to change it into negative, you will write what will not Ram, what will Ram not have been shopping. What will Ram not have been shopping? So this is how you can frame all these sentences. I hope everything is clear to you. We have done with all the tenses now, all the 12 tenses now. We'll meet in the next class. Till then, stay home, stay safe, be happy, and do practice of tenses. Thank you.